So the examples that we're looking at get pretty good occupancy. In general, how do you affect the occupancy of a kernel? Well, it's usually fairly easy to control the amount of shared memory needed by a thread block. For example, in our transpose kernel, that would be the tile size. And of course, you can change the number of threads and thread blocks that you launch when you launch your kernel. You can also work with a compiler to control the number of registers a kernel uses, though this qualifies as a ninja-level optimization and isn't usually worth the trouble. So increasing occupancy is usually but not always a good thing, and it only helps up to a point. It exposes more parallelism to the GPU and allows more memory transactions in flight, but it may force the GPU to run less efficiently when taken too far. This is always a trade-off. For example, decreasing the tile size in the transpose code will let more thread blocks run, it decreases the amount of time spent waiting at barriers, but if we get to too small a tile, we'll lose the whole point of tiling, which was to coalesce the global memory accesses. So let's go back to that transpose code. So here's our kernel, and you'll recall that we concluded that this sync threads was really the problem. We need it there, but we've got a large thread block, 32 by 32 threads, 1024 total threads, and most of the time, most of those threads are simply sitting at this barrier waiting for the rest of the threads to reach the barrier before they can proceed. So we conclude that maybe we can make this faster by simply going up and changing to 16 by 16 blocks. A very small change that should decrease the amount of time that we spend waiting at a barrier and therefore decrease the latency between memory operations, which by Little's law we would expect to let us increase the total bandwidth. So now we'll compile and run. And sure enough, this time we took just over 0.53 milliseconds. So let's update our running tally of results. The tiled version of our code, we managed to get about half a millisecond by adjusting the tile size. So here's a programming exercise. Let's go back to the transpose code and try a few different tile sizes and see which ones work best. Try 8x8, 16 by 16, 32 by 32, and 64 by 64 tiles. This last one will be trickier because, of course, this is more elements than you can put threads in a thread block. So you'll have to think about how to pack this into a single thread block. And I should point out, we're looking for the relative ranking of these on the Udacity servers. So using the Fermi-based GPUs as opposed to, for example, your own machine that you might be developing on at home.